Bruising Banner Podcast. What up, what up, what up? Welcome to Bruising Banner Podcast. I'm your host, Rob G. And with me, as always, is the legendary Brew Crew. What up, fella?
I got water, I got, you know, juice or whatever. Like, got any twin legs? Matter of fact,
my
I do.
My question to everybody is,
does Dunkelberg have an actual culture?
This is the podcast that we talk about beer, but we also talk about a lot of things that's happening in the world. Politics, movies, anything really that comes to our mind while we're here sampling these brews. Grab a drink and pull up a chair.
Holy Jesus. I gotta drop all these toys off. Mrs. Claus! Mrs. Claus, bring me my robes and my slippers! I gotta go!
Smell the pine trees in the air, sleigh bells are ringing. Toy stores are out of control, the kids singing. That night before Christmas, dancing through the snow. Food off the reindeer, red nose that glow. It's all about the candy canes and Christmas lists. North Pole and that chubby jolly old Saint Nick. The little elves getting busy, it's in the workshop. And how gingerbread men keep their buttons on top. Wooden soldiers and chestnuts roasting like marshmallows. Goodfellas trying to put in pies and jellos.
Clap it up for the Wi-Fi.
Marshmallows, pudding pops, and jellos.
Yeah, yeah. That was your boy Ghostface doing his Christmas.
Oh, we know.
Song.
I mean, everybody shouldn't do Christmas songs. I'm going to be honest.
Everybody should attempt. I think.
You think so?
Yeah, you should give it. Mm-hmm. Everybody should try.
Everybody should attempt.
If you want to, you should. Yep.
Even drop out singers or rap.
Album. You shouldn't do an album.
Oh.
But one
singers or rappers
compilation. I think like every year in like June, they should just send out the mass email like, hey, we about to do the Christmas compilation. Who want to get on this joint?
Let's see if you make the butt
and
for
every
that
year,
Christmas
every
album.
Year, every year on Black Friday, drop the compilation for this year.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Kind of like the Masco's wrap up and then you got your Christmas compilation and your Masco wrap up.
No. I disagree.
You disagree on what?
Be honest. About the Christmas. About
right.
The Christmas.
Look, submit your song. See if you make the cut.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Yeah, like if it's 30 people, if it's 30 songs, we only putting 9 to 11 songs on the song.
Yo,
I think the young boys do it better because actually Sway Lee's Christmas song ain't too bad.
Wait, I like Sway Lee.
Yeah,
I like
that Ghostface. That Ghostface right there though.
But he can be one of Halloween. Like, if you producing this year, you would cut that from the joint. Like maybe we see you in 2022.
Yeah, that would be cut.
Right. Maybe you can come back if we low on songs next year. We'll put you through. But go back to the booth and learn some.
That's probably with a song on the album that he just took. He replaced words and put Christmas words in it, and that's how he ran with it.
Shit, that's terrible. That's
what it sounds like. That shit scared me.
Marshmallows and jellos.
Motherfucker, you ain't
like marshmallows
with the jellos. I beat a nigga in the head. Merry Christmas, little bitch.
Right. Ho, 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 he called her ho, ho, ho as he ran down the street.
All right. What up, what up, what up? Welcome to Bruising Banter Podcast, where the topic is the rocket and the brew. Well, that be the fuel. I'm your host, Rob G, and with me, as always, the legendary Brew Crew. What's going on, fellas? Merry Christmas. Happy holidays.
All that Merry good Christmas.
Happy Christmas.
Happy Christmas.
Merry holidays.
Happy Kwanzaa.
Rosh Hashanah. Is it Rosh Hashanah?
No, it's Hanukkah. But Hanukkah already passed.
Hanukkah.
I think Hanukkah's over though, right? Yeah. What is it?
Is it over?
I don't know. Well,
I don't
if
know.
It's not,
a lot of candles.
It is. It is part of the holiday season. It is part of the holiday season.
That is true. Nice. So to all my Jewish brothers and sisters, happy brothers. Hanukkah. Brothers and sisters.
So let me ask the question: was everybody was everyone good on Christmas? Did Santa bring you lots of gifts and goodies and candy and whatever they say that's on the sleigh? You know that song, lots of toys and goodies on his sleigh and every mother's child. That song,
Yeah, yeah. We know. What?
What, last year?
So was everybody good for Christmas?
Yeah. I guess I'm big.
When is this coming out?
It comes out Tuesday, so Christmas.
Right.
Christmas won't be here yet.
Right. Well, then why the hell did you say Merry Christmas at the top then?
Because we won't be back.
It's the last episode. Until, yeah, we won't be back until New Year's Eve.
That's all I was talking about.
That's why I thought we was taping this for Christmas episode.
Ladies and gentlemen, and Devin, this is our official Christmas episode. This is the last episode of 2021. We will be back.
That just goes to show how shoddy our communication is.
Yo, nah, that nigga went to Montclair. That nigga went to Montclair. Montclair went to a time warp.
Shit, I should have stayed in Montclair.
He was like, Merry Christmas. What you guys get for Christmas?
Yeah, well, this is episode 147. The holiday episode. So we hope you do. Like Lou said, we won't be back until the new year. So you wanted to come on and say Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays, Hanukkah, Kwanzaa, Happy New Year, all that good stuff.
Happy New Year. Happy New Year, New You. Nah, fuck that shit.
But like always, nothing changed. Before we get into it, we always like to know what we're drinking on, so. What are we drinking today? Lou, what you drinking on?
Nope, not me. I'm not ready.
Nope, not ready.
Dang.
I saw you crack
yours open.
Devil saw me crack on. Mine. Well, I am sipping on a raspberry blonde ale with raspberries, courtesy of my man Lou Man 2.
Devin, you on fire tonight, baby.
You're on fire tonight. Even a raspberry blonde ale with raspberries. What the fuck is
this? I love it,
man. Let's read the can again in case you just didn't hear. I'm drinking a raspberry blonde ale with raspberries. So I'm going to read it again for you.
Okay.
I did pass reading.
Because the can says it. That's why.
I'm going to read the way the can says it.
Cheers. Okay. Cheers. Before it sounded like a good joke.
So this is a chocolate stout
with chocolate.
It might be with double raspberries. There's a reason. We just don't know why they put it on the can twice. Right. There's a reason.
That's true.
This is by Four Noses Brewing Company, based in Colorado. Let me just see where. Bloomfield, Colorado, that is. Bloomfield. Fresh fruit, effervescence, harmonious. This is coming in at a whopping 6.3%, 12 IBUs. And to be honest, I'm enjoying it. Really, really, you see like light in color, but It's like you taste the raspberries on the palate, but you also smell it, but not as profound when you inhale it. But you taste it definitely. This is that kind of ale that give you a good belch. You know, it'd be like after you ate something good, you'd be like, oh, I need this. So pass me another. This was
the effervescence. Mm-hmm. Speaking of eating something good, what would you eat with it, with Dev?
Not good question.
Not burger.
To be honest,
raspberries.
Not burger. However, I would actually probably enjoy this with like
spicy.
Nah, like maybe like you know like a not like your general like just with fries, but something like starchy. So like something like a you know like fried potatoes or something that's like greasy
like a brunch. Like a brunch,
yeah, like yeah, almost like a steak or even like potatoes and eggs or something. Potatoes, so yeah, like
scrambled eggs,
exactly, yeah, something yeah, like yeah. that.
I got you. I was thinking like crab legs or some type of crab cake or something like that.
Yeah,
that's what I was thinking with that.
Yeah, something fried, something you know, something like that.
I mean, I drank mine yesterday, and I think I was eating like a taco bowl. I think that thing can go good with anything, to be honest, because it's kind of so light.
You think it paired well with it?
Yeah, I thought it did. I thought it was pretty good because because it was steak tacos too. So
okay. It was just like, was your steak spicy?
Yeah, because I always put like the hot fucking.
Yeah. So that's probably so that's why, good, yeah, that's that was a good balance. That's why that was a good balance. Then.
Yeah, that's why I asked that.
Yeah.
Yeah, but that shit was good. It was like, yeah, I like that. I like that.
Nice.
Yeah.
All right. Yep. All right. All right. Yo, what you drinking on?
This. I got a beer.
Uh oh.
This from Left Hand. From Left Hand, bro.
Oh.
Right?
I know. I know which one that is.
But this is this. This is that tequila. Barrel aged grapefruit.
That shit is so good.
Yo. Oh, it's so good.
Right? Now, one thing I did notice about this as I was reading through the bottle is that it says something on the back about, okay, it's called Paloma Resposado. Am I saying that right?
That's close enough.
Resposado.
Resposado. Okay, yes. Okay. And this says it is your day drinking barrel aged beer. Houseway, and it's a 10-point.
I agree.
That's false advertising.
It's you think so?
Day drinking? You can't drink that all day. How many are you going to drink in one day?
Yeah, you're drinking a day. Go to nap. Take a nap and be ready for the next.
I'm about to say,
the next day.
I could see that being a day drink. You gonna sip it.
Flavor wise,
because tequilas pack a punch, and people drink tequilas. You know what I mean, and have margaritas. You know, all day, right?
True.
So yeah, I hear you.
I think it could be a good day drink because it was still very like still had that good fruit taste to it.
Yeah. So I think it does have the grapefruit taste to it still. Not real strong on the citrusy side, but you can still taste
it. Is it more tequila than anything for you? Mm-hmm.
It smells like the tequila's in there. You can smell the tequila. I think the tequila gives it kind of a lighter flavor. You know how like when you mix, when you put the salt on the rim, when you're taking a shot, right? Mm-hmm. It kind of cuts back on the out to the tequila.
You know how people take shots of lime or sometimes they use cinnamon with their tequila. I never thought about grapefruit. I wonder how it would be to hit the grapefruit at the end of your tequila shot.
That might be all right. Yeah, but that okay. So I can see that.
You want to try that tomorrow?
That's kind of what's happening in this glass, though.
I tried tomorrow.
It's kind of what's happening here.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
Like, on the back end of it, like the flavor of the grapefruit's on the back end.
And so like you said, like, that salty is like as soon as you taste it, it's boom.
Yeah,
that's a Left Hand be fucking it up, man. Like how do they do that? Like how they do the whole process of a shot of a tequila shot, bro. That's
Yo, speaking of tequila, I saw Alicia Keys on Drink Champs, and she said she put a jalapeno in her shit.
Oh,
jalapeno.
A hot one or just a regular?
Yo, that interview was funny.
Hot one, yeah.
Okay.
Yep.
Jalapeno,
I'm going to try that shit. Yeah.
Jalapenos and grapefruits now. Jalapenos, cinnamons, and grapefruits.
But I've seen jalapenos. Yo, 2022,
we fucking tequila. 2022, we fucking tequila.
So, yo, I didn't read on the bottle, but is there anywhere that it says that it was a Reposado barrel? Because I wonder how they would do, because I think the Reposado means how long it was in the barrel, but I don't know why they would call it, a Reposado.
Well, they said barrel aged, so it must have been tequila barrel.
Right, tequila barrel, but what I'm saying is, like, did they age it to a Reposado? I wonder why they called it Reposado, because Reposado, there's añejo, there's like two or three other types of tequila, and it's based on how long it was sitting in the barrel, how long it was aged.
4 months.
I gotta talk to them. I wonder if Left Hand makes añejo or Blanco version or whatever.
Because it was beer, they couldn't age it too long.
Right. But I'm saying like. Reposado, I don't know how long it ages for, but I'm not sure if it's 4 months. You know what I mean? So maybe the añejo would be like 6 months. You know what I'm saying? Like they just cut it shorter, even though it because it's beer instead.
Man, well done, call añejo. This is añejo. Man, shut up.
I called añejo ho 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 all the way down the street. Merry Christmas.
Ho ho.
But I was passing.
That's what's up. 2 for 2, Colorado. That's Square right. State doing good things with their beer.
I know, okay. man.
Before I get to ask, get to you, Lou, yeah. why do you call Christmas? I mean, why don't you ever see Santa in the hospital?
That's a great question. That besides being a joke, that's just a great question. Why?
Why don't you ever see him?
Because he has private elf care.
No, I wanted the joke to be better than that.
Private elf care? Fuck that joke. Whoever even came up with it was just, they was digging. They was reaching for that one. That was
reaching.
I thought that was pretty funny. Little checking on.
Jesus. That's funny. Well, since it's the holiday season, we're celebrating today. We went to Barrel and Flow. We always talk about Barrel and Flow, but we went to Barrel and Flow and we met a fan of the show. His name was Brian. He's from Maryland.
Oh yeah,
and right. He handed us all some beers, and he gave me this beer right here. Can y'all see that?
It's specific. Mm-hmm. That was just
right. It came in a box. It came in a box and shit.
Right.
I felt real.
That motherfucker hooked them up like Will Smith in that book shit.
Right. Mm. Right. Like Charlamagne got the book. Yeah. Yeah, he did. So I appreciate you, Brian. I'm tasting it now. It's a perfect occasion. It is a Firestone. This is their 23rd anniversary ale from Firestone Walker Brewing Company. As you can see, it's in a 12-ounce bottle here. Beer before glory seems to be the motto. This is a limited release back in 2019, as y'all saw that bottle said. I don't know.
Dark.
Yeah, it is. It's brewed in Paso Robles, California. Mm-hmm. But I don't know what kind of I guess it's just the ale, but it's a dark ass ale.
That thing dark.
Yeah, and this shit, right, man. I gotta go to work in the morning. If any,
it look like that from sitting in that bottle since 2000.
Maybe, but this shit vintage. It's vintage. That's the vintage color. That's a that T-year vintage.
Was gold.
Brown ale.
Go ahead, Luke.
I'm playing. I've been drinking that thing. No, I already did. It's delicious.
I didn't even see you sip the cup.
What was the ABV you said?
Bro, I gotta go to work in the morning.
Oh, I gotta go to work in the morning.
No, I fucked up. It's 11.5. I fucked up because I gotta finish this. It's delicious. Got to finish this. But Brian, yo, appreciate you, bro. This was delicious. If you get your hands on more, send it because this is good. This shit was good. Pass me all the way down. Happy holidays, everyone.
Yeah. Why is it getting harder? Yeah.
Oh shit. Never mind. Oh. Go ahead.
Why is it getting harder to buy advent calendars?
Tell us.
It's so quiet.
Because their days are numbered.
That's good.
He's hilarious to me.
That's a good one. Advent days are numbered. You count the days off. That's good. Y'all know what advent is, everyone. Anyone does it, that's what it means.
Yeah.
Yeah. Happy Advent, anyone. What's Advent for? Is that Catholic people? Catholics. Okay. Catholic religion. I think so. I went to Catholic school. I should know, maybe.
I should know, maybe.
It was a while ago.
All right. You did ask me what I was drinking.
Rob G, what are you drinking for this Christmas holiday episode?
I am drinking day number two of 12 Days of Smoogie. Right there. There we go.
Okay. Oh, that's good. You can see that real good right there.
It's called poinsettia
or poinsettia?
Yeah, it's called poinsettia.
Poinsettia?
And the poinsettia?
I think it's poinsettia. I've heard people say poinsettia, but I believe poinsettia is correct.
Yeah. That's how I've always heard it.
The people be eddying it up all the time.
Yeah, you know the English language. I think we talked about English language.
English language is trash.
Right. We did.
But this is a cranberry, apple, orange, buckle, because if anybody didn't know, the 12 days of smoogies, they don't tell you until the day of what it is, tell you the name of it, but they don't tell you what it's actually in the can until that day. So today is day two.
It
is a cranberry, apple, orange, buckle, which is, I guess, is like an ale. Nice. Yeah.
I thought you messed up your word. I heard buckle the first time, and I'm like, he ain't say that right. But you did. So what's a buckle?
I said buckle.
What
it's like that? An L. I'm assuming it's like a blonde ale.
It's the type of beer. The buckle is the style.
Yeah. So this is a seasonal buckle made with dark cherries. I mean, dark cranberries, fall apples, and Florida oranges with a touch of maple. When they say touch,
the oranges from Florida.
When they say touch of orange, they tell you touch of maple, they lying like a motherfucker. This is all maple syrup.
It's like maple syrup.
Right.
It's Florida oranges. What else?
Cranberries, dark cranberries, and seasonal fall apples.
All that shit would go good with maple syrup. That's why, like, the maple syrup is tasting real good with apples and shit. Right.
And I think
caramelize the apples. That's maple syrup cousin.
I saw a lot of people saying that the maple syrup dominated, but I don't think they rotated their cup. They're thinking enough because there is a lot of maple syrup, but I can taste the apples in there. Mm-hmm. Not too much the oranges or the cranberry, but definitely apple. And maple syrup.
Well, apple is strong anyway. You know what I mean? Right.
And apple maple syrup. Yeah, maybe apple and maple syrup have to and take orange that. Don't really go too well.
What?
You it does have a lot. Pour that in your glass and then stir it.
Stirred it up.
Yeah.
There you go.
Put a little spoon in that thing.
That thing look real strawberry milky. That look like
definitely always have lactose in it, so it does have lactose in it.
Yeah, it do look creamy.
Yeah.
It looks like a flute.
Why you grinding like that?
Yes,
yeah.
Creamy.
That's that Robert Kelly coming out in here.
False.
That's funny. That is funny. What funny today?
But I will pass me another on that for sure.
Okay.
I enjoyed it. I'm looking forward to the next 10 days. I got 10 more beers to drink.
Got that Christmas Wi-Fi.
10 more drinks. But I do have while we're here, I do have some Christmas trivia.
Oh, no, this is crazy.
Here we go. I'll start with something easy. What popular Christmas beverage is also called milk punch?
Eggnog.
You got it, sir. You should get a prize. Or should have been a number. Ding.
Mm-hmm. All right. He got 1 point. Let's see who's going to win.
How many questions is these?
It's got 50, but I'm not going to do 50.
All right, do like 10.
Right.
You can skip around.
Oh yeah, I already plan to. What? No.
Everybody won't get points over me.
And
we can't hear you.
Everybody going to get points over me. Me.
He sound grumpy and everything.
Shizaki.
He froze.
Oh no.
He froze.
Oh no. His mugshot scary time. He looked like a dang. Dude. Like, there you go. Nope.
Oh, he gotta go out and in.
You want out.
Answer that question. Yeah. Only two of us playing.
Music break, baby.
Hey.
Santa know when you good or bad.
Who's that? Kurt
Franklin? Jim Jones.
Oh shit, thanks Rob. What channel is this? Hip Hop Merry Christmas.
Hey.
Yo man, I agree with y'all. I agree with my theory. We should put names in a hat. Everybody get to put their Christmas album compilation out every year. I think that should be a thing.
Yeah, I'm not mad at it. Well, because if it's like something like that, where kind of like competitive, they'll probably try a little harder. Because sometimes it might just be a money grab.
Yeah,
like,
I'm
just no money grabs. We know we're gonna go platinum every time. Just have some good songs behind it. Let's try to get a Mariah Carey at least once a year.
Right.
I'm not a Mariah Carey, but All I Want for Christmas type of song.
Right. I don't think Ghostface went platinum with that.
Nah, bro. But that's why I was saying to Yoda's point. you can submit as many as you want. And if it's only 8 good ones, we only going to put out 8 this year. If it's 10 good ones, we'll put out 10 and blah, blah, blah. But we not putting out Ghostface if he don't make the top. Like, nah, bro. Go. I agree with y'all. Ghostface just put out a...
Just nothing from Ghostface.
Never? He can't try again next year?
I don't know what year that was, actually. Nah. So
it don't matter what year it was. It was bad. Any year.
It would have been bad any year.
Right. This year, next year. It's going to be bad in 2023. It'll be bad in 2033.
I'd rather jump back into my trivia.
Trivia.
In Home Alone, where are the McAllisters going on vacation when they leave Kevin behind?
Paris.
Florida.
Paris.
Oh, I thought we were talking about the second one. I was saying Home Alone. That just goes to show which one I recently watched.
I was about to say that. I just saw Home Alone 1 this weekend.
I think 2 is actually my favorite. I think I like 2 more than I like 1. I don't know why. I think I do.
When he got trapped in New York and then they were in Florida.
Yeah.
Like, as adults, so I still like him like that?
Oh, I still watch it.
It was a hard watch for me this weekend, Yoda. I was just wondering, like, why would the thieves go into the house with the kid? Like, that never made any sense. They know the kid's in there. Like, if the kids see you, you gotta murder the kid, right? And y'all are thieves. Y'all not murderers.
Okay.
They didn't really want to murder the kid until he started fucking with them.
Thanks for making that Christmas movie.
Yeah, it's bad. They should have killed
him. Yeah, keep it light, Lou.
No, let's be real with this movie right now. They should have killed them fucking kids. That kid should have been dead a long time ago.
His mom should have killed him.
He was a jerk.
He was an asshole, bro.
If the wet bandits would have got their hands on him, he just was too slick. They would have killed him. They would have hung him by his neck suffocated him.
What I'm saying is the movie should... I know the movie has to happen, but the movie shouldn't ever happen because they should have never even went to that house because they knew someone was there. Right, you know what I mean? Yeah. But they was like, we want that house so bad. That's the reason why we in this neighborhood. Man, y'all got so much shit in that van.
Right.
Go hop that shit and go to the next place and be good. And
but then they did rob one other house and then they came to that house.
They robbed like 3 or 4 of them joints. Right. They robbed the whole neighborhood.
Right.
And then like another last question. If a cop is in your house randomly, don't you want to see some ID? Is it okay?
Too many people. It was too many people running around. And this was like 1993.
All right.
Streets was safer.
All right. Well, people didn't think
they
that
definitely
much.
Wasn't. They wasn't at the McAllister neighborhood. The motherfuckers were getting robbed left and right.
Well, it's funny because somebody posted, I don't know, maybe it was one of y'all that posted that if this was happening, if Home Alone was in 2021. And it'd just be like, Mom, you left me at home. Oh, I'm gonna get off the plane right now. Like he would text her.
Yeah.
And the movie be over.
Right. Well, there is a new Home Alone movie, right? Y'all know that, right?
Yeah.
My kids watched.
No, there's one like on Disney Plus. My kids watched it on Saturday, I think.
Yeah, they watched. Yeah, mine too.
Yo, what do y'all think about this? This is my last theory about Home Alone. Instead of I got a lot more, but
I like your theories. Go ahead. Yeah,
thank you, man. What did y'all think about Home Alone 1 being just that Kevin and that family, and then Home Alone 2? I know it was such a blockbuster that they had to do it with Kevin and the rest of the family, but every Home Alone just being a whole different family, a whole different setup, because it's kind of ridiculous that it happened again to the same family.
Right.
Less than a year, literally a year later. Like, what the hell? Like, come on. I don't care. I'm ruined it. I don't care.
Well, you know, I think to your point, he wasn't home alone.
He wasn't home alone.
The second one?
They thought they had, I guess you would say, they had a bulletproof plan the second time around, right? They were like, okay, we at least got out the house this time with him and got to the airport. And I counted everybody. I did everything. And it just goes to show, but it goes back to that rule. You know how your parents used to drill you into like, don't separate from them when you go to a store, and it kind of played on those kinds of theory, on those kinds of like just lessons that like, this is why you need to stay by my side. Cause the smallest little deviation could.
I blame my dad. Nigga, don't give him no fucking batteries. You get the batteries when we get on the plane. You know, hey, here's my bag. Check the bag. Is my battery
We already lost you once, young man. You come with me. Matter of fact, I know you need batteries. Put your hand in the bag. Let me zip your hand up.
She should have fired on Pop, but now you lost him this time.
Yeah. Was, it's low key. John Candy was awesome in part one. I really like John Candy and the Poker Brothers in part one.
Right. Yeah, yeah.
But y'all didn't ever answer the question. What y'all think about if they would have just did every Home Alone with a different family?
Well, I guess a different style of Kevin.
It probably would work now. Back then, it probably wouldn't work. But
because of the blockbuster of it all.
Yeah, and just because of how people watch movies, they watch. I mean, if you didn't want to watch Michael J. You didn't want to watch Back to the Future 2 without Michael J. Fox in it. That's just how blockbusters work.
I think you know, like you said, it can work now. It could have worked, I think, back in the day, but I think that viewers are so keen on not letting their childhood stars grow up that it wouldn't have been, you know, a hit. Where now you're right, like it doesn't really matter as much.
Because you can start
to see, you know, now you start to see childhood stars like in different movies, or you actually watch them grow up and they didn't grow up like on one show. Like you see them kind of in one show and then they're like, oh, they're in this, you know, my kids see them. They're like, oh, they're in this too. Right. But you see them like growing up on TV and kind of maturing and stuff like that. But back in the day, you know, everybody wanted your childhood star to stay the age they were when they first started.
Well, yeah, and because it was once you start getting acting, your voice did get deeper. They like, time to go, brother.
Time to go.
What's that? Joel Osment? Joel Osment?
Because he grew up, but he don't look no different. He's just older.
Still didn't want him.
What happened? Well, especially guys, people like that, because even the boy from what was it? Home Improvement. I can't remember his name.
Oh, the Oombop boy, the one who looked like one of the Oombops.
Yeah. That I would never put it that way, but yeah, I guess
you knew what I was talking about, though.
Oombop boy. Well, he was the one that
you knew what I was talking about. You're the one who was trying to describe him. My bad.
Well, he was the one that had the more successful career.
He was the middle kid.
Middle kid.
Home Improvement.
Was there more than one? Was it more than two kids? Oh yeah, the girl. There were three boys.
Three boys. Yeah.
I don't even remember the third boy then. My bad, bro. I remember that motherfucker at all.
Oh, shit. That's funny.
Here's another one. Which Hollywood actor played six different roles in The Polar Express?
Oh, yeah.
Tom Hanks.
There you go, Tom Hanks.
Dang, that seemed like that would have been easy. I should have just guessed. He's the only person in the movie.
Pretty much was.
I didn't know. He was a train conductor. Yeah, I didn't know. I never seen.
Wasn't he the train? Like he was a train conductor. He was. I think he was one of the voices when they were like talking on the phone when they were like. I don't know if he was the elf voice or if he was like up at the North Pole in that capacity. Mm-hmm. I don't know. I don't know many more, but I definitely that's what my choice
was. Yeah, he probably was like one or two where you don't.
Yeah, he didn't catch it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
One in one, Lou.
No, I got two, baby.
Oh, you got two? Oh, that's right, because you got Home Alone and you got the eggnog.
Yep.
And the eggnog. Okay, here's a good one. Which country started the tradition of putting up a Christmas tree?
I'm wrong. Man. I know I'm wrong. Hungary.
Australia.
It's Germany.
It was Germany. Yeah, it is Germany. So you.
Yeah, I was like, I knew it was one of them too. When he said Australia, I'm like, should I get half a point for that?
No. We both got it wrong.
That's funny.
Well, I think Yoda had technical difficulties, so he is
out.
Merry Christmas and Happy New Year, Yoda.
Yeah, he is out. I don't doubt if nobody get that one. That'd be a little difficult. Okay. What was the real name of the character Tim Allen plays in the Santa Claus?
Kris Kringle.
The real name of what was his name?
Tim Allen, I remember. Okay, in Simple.
You motherfucker.
Roy.
John. Jim. Jake.
Scott Calvin. I wouldn't have got that either.
Scott Calvin. That's a Santa Claus. SC.
That was a tough one.
That's why his name was Scott. They could have found a better SC than Scott Calvin.
Yeah. Yeah, I guess they could have.
Yeah.
Scott Coachman. Scott Christopher. Scott.
Scott. Know. No Scott. Take Scott
y'all
out of
to, it. Then y'all get taught by a man named Mr. Cooch. You could have made him Scott Cooch.
Or you could have been like Sam. Sam.
Why, Lou?
Because that's what his name was.
Oh, man. Damn.
I think that's probably why they went with Calvin. He was like, nah, not Cooch.
Can't be Cooch.
Cooch!
Mr. Cooch. Come here, Mr. Cooch.
What's every parent's favorite Christmas carol? This is a joke, actually.
Jingle Bells.
No.
Silent Night.
Christmas.
Silent Night.
Oh.
Nobody wanted that shit.
Darn.
Take your ass to bed, kids.
That thing will put you to sleep.
Santa Claus gotta wrap these gifts tonight. Go to bed.
Silent tonight. Silent night.
I'm in the holiday spirit. I'm not a grouch or a grinch. A grinch.
Yes.
Yeah, sure.
What eyes are all aglow in the Christmas song? He scratches it already.
I just know their eyes are all aglow. Whose eyes are all aglow?
Whose eyes are all aglow?
It's like two bars before.
The kids.
Tiny Tots.
Tiny Tots. Yeah, the kids. Eyes are all aglow.
I was going to say kids. I knew it was kids.
I got it, baby.
You going to give them that?
Yeah, that's Tiny Tots. That's like Family Feud.
That's fine, but I was really thinking about Tiny Tots. Oh, man, we bucking the system.
Yeah, that's a good one.
Here's for your math whiz. For you math wizards, how many gifts in total were given in the 12 days of Christmas song?
13.
Mm-mm, it's more than that. 12 was given on the 12th
day. Oh, right, because it's 12. Oh, I'm about to say it's 12.
12 plus 11 12, plus 10. It's like 23. An algorithm to get that shit. You should be able to get it real fast, and real math people do, but I can't. 113.
Hold on. Don't give it away yet.
I know why. I know why it's that many.
How many?
I ain't giving it away yet.
I thought he said it.
He said 300 and something. I heard him say that. So I know it's like 367. But it's because every time you sing the shit on the first day of Christmas, every time you say first day, so it's 12 partridges in a pear tree. God damn it. That's stupid. That's a riddle.
364. Then now you know.
So it actually turns out to be damn near every day.
Yeah.
I gave you a present every day.
That wasn't going to be my answer.
I gave you a present every day of the year except for Christmas. God damn it, you greedy bastard. 360, Devin, you'll never forget it now. No, 364.
Maybe the calendar was different back then.
It could be. Sometimes they'd be putting that leap year in there, you know what I mean? Maybe they would have took it away a couple days.
Maybe it was the deduction year. What do you call leap backwards? What is that called?
A hopscotch year.
Subtract year.
It's a peel. Just spell it backwards. Peel year.
That'd be interesting. I wonder if people actually did that back in the day where sometime it's 364 days, 65.
Yeah, all this shit's made up anyway. Somebody a long, long time ago made this shit up, man.
Right. I mean, that's anything. I mean,
we may have lived 18 years this whole one year.
That is
sometimes
true.
People think it feels like it.
Yeah. Here's an easy one. How do you say Merry Christmas in Spanish?
Feliz Navidad.
Feliz Navidad.
Feliz Navidad.
All right, I think that's a, I don't know. I lost count. I think that was 10.
Yeah, I won.
No, you won. You won that.
One, I know. One by default.
By default. Devin wasn't listening. That's what you said.
I wasn't listening.
No, that's a dumb joke. I don't like that one.
Yo, what's that? What's going on with your hat, Rob?
It's my antlers.
Does it flap? Oh no.
No, I don't flap. Unless you make it flap.
Are you Donner?
I'm Rudolph.
You can't be Rudolph, man. Everybody wants to be Rudolph.
Well, that's who I am.
Do you think that you think they were teasing him, or were all the reindeers teasing him?
Probably every reindeer, because he was definitely
the top eight. It wasn't the top eight. The top eight was probably wasn't even worrying about him. They the jocks.
Well, no, they probably weren't about him too. I think everybody, because he was different and he was like the nerd kind of thing, because he had a red nose. Nobody else had a red nose.
He wasn't the nerd. He was like the dude that came in new that couldn't dress.
Sure. Okay.
Yeah. Rudolph ain't know that math. Rudolph didn't know 364 days. Nah.
No, he probably smart. He probably smart. Because he got that sleigh.
It don't take much when you got a light bulb for a nose.
You got no latitude and longitude. No?
I think eventually, yes. But I don't think that first night. I think that first night, Santa was in a bind. Santa was like, "Oh, nigga, I need a light."
Oh shit, that's a mountain. No, my bad.
He was like, "Just fly high, fly high. We'll figure it out from there."
Yeah, because what did he do before he got Rudolph?
It was never a foggy night.
Because
of that elf check character out, he had. Dude. He would always
it was never a foggy night.
It could have been.
So what did he do after it was no longer foggy night? Did he put Rudolph down? I say, I'm getting dark like
oh, you. Oh, shit. Yo, that's worse than the Home Alone theory. You can't kill Rudolph after one Christmas.
I won't need you, motherfucker.
Nah, after that, Rudolph was studded out, and he made a lot more little Rudolphs.
He was studded out.
Yeah, we had Rudolphs.
He dropped him.
Is that how deer work? I don't know.
He dropped him. He dropped
him. If you got a red ball, if you flying reindeer, and you got one that got a nose with a red, you going to stud that motherfucker out. He got to make babies. He got to.
I got you.
Yeah. He the rich, Santa Claus is the richest. Is he an elf? Saint? He the richest one. He the richest one. Because he got Rudolph.
True.
Them stud fees is a lot of money for a red-nosed reindeer.
I did go to Blitzen. So I guess I could be Blitzen. We have a Blitzen bar here in Delaware. Wilmington, actually. It's actually pretty cool. It's decorated like a... it's kind of weird, though. It's called Blitzen.
Mm-hmm.
But it has reindeer antler as decor. I don't know if he would have reindeer antler.
Yeah, if Blitzen walked in there, I think he would be really, really upset.
Right, like, I don't think that's accurate. I'm a cannibal. I shot this motherfucker right here.
Like, could you put some grass and foliage up on the walls? That's what I eat. That's what I take down. I don't know what's going on with my cousin. You took my cousin down and put him up on your wall.
Unless it was like a cremation, so that was like their urn type of thing. And when they pass away, you stuck them on the wall. As honorary, as a memorial. Welcome to the dark Christmas special.
Right, this is morbid as shit.
Happy holidays, motherfuckers.
Jesus, what other crazy, nasty ass question you got up there that's going to talk about death? Jesus.
What do you call a broke Santa? Don't worry. It's dumb. Saint Nicholas.
Saint Nicholas.
Okay.
All right.
All right.
We're gonna accept that one.
All right. I'll move on from Christmas jokes. Anybody watch Drake and Ye?
I fell asleep.
You know, I fell asleep. You gotta give the whole review, Rob.
Right, because your partner in crime ain't even here either. He's all stayed up.
Because I fell asleep.
I got all ready and everything. I put my dressed up. Blanket.
You got dressed up.
Yo, I took my blanket downstairs. Had it ready to go on the.
That's where you fucked up.
Did it start on time?
Hell no.
No.
That's where you fucked up. You brought a,
that's where
brought
it a did. Blanket.
You brought a blanket. You already knew. Nighty night. Right.
Old man brought his blanket down. Like, you know what?
I keep that thermostat set to 68, 69. I don't be likely to pay them large winter bills.
Yeah, because when I logged on, because it was supposed to start at like 8 o'clock Pacific time, so it's like 11 o'clock here.
Right.
So I logged on. As soon as I logged on, I said I should change to 9 Pacific time. I was like, So I was like, all right, let me. Right. I'll take my shower, do all stuff, do what I need to do. So then I was laying down and I fell asleep at like 11:30. I must have been like,
damn.
But as soon as Praise God came on, I woke up, and that was like right when they were walking out. I was like, it was like at this point it was 12:46. I was like,
oh my gosh, are you kidding me?
I was just like, damn.
No, man. No. That's so disrespectful. Yeah, that's so disrespectful.
I was like, oh shit, they're just starting. I thought I may miss something. I was like, oh no. They walking out.
Oh man. Right. People in England thought they was gonna miss it and they just waking up to see it. Jesus. Yeah.
I was like, come on, bro. I mean, I should have known. I mean, Kanye is notorious, especially now. He's like Lauryn Hill, but he actually does eventually come out. Mm-hmm. Like, at least he does. You know, eventually he will be there. She will not. She's not. Mm-hmm.
I may be there. I may not.
I think they said she has gotten better over the years. They were actually supposed to do a Fuji reunion tour, but I think they postponed it till the 2020.
Yeah, my drummer in my band, he plays for them, so he told me it's delayed.
It was good to see them all together, though.
Did y'all know that the Fuji song Ready or Not was a remake?
Yeah.
Did you know who the remake is by? The Jackson 5?
I don't know.
I mean, the original is the Jackson 5. They right, sing, right. It's called Ready or Not. They sing the damn song that Lauryn Hill sung, pretty much word for word. I heard it today.
Wow. I might have known that, actually.
It's been
so long. I mean, how long was Fuji? It seemed like forever. I don't know. That's how you know I'm getting old. Oh,
yo.
Shit. I am old then.
This Jackson 5 album came out in 1970.
Right.
Well, that tour is going to be starting in March now.
Okay. That should be it. That should be a solid tour. I mean, if you add Wyclef's solo joints, all of Lauryn Hill's joints, because Fuji's, I mean, the score was dope. I mean, even Happy.
It's not a lot of cities though.
I'm sure that she probably said I only do three.
Cali, Florida, Georgia, DC, Jersey, Chicago.
I was close. I said three. That's about close enough.
I like that though. I like that because like you said, they got a catalog, but it's not really, really extensive for a band that's been out that long. They only got two albums together. Right. You know what I mean? And do we want to see Prize's solo shit? No.
He could get out there and do Ghetto Superstar.
No, look, Rob.
That shit was a hit. Ghetto Superstar.
Okay, that one song.
That one song. You can't get out there and do his whole catalog.
No.
That's what he said.
He just did his whole catalog,
right?
Devin.
Right.
That's what I'm saying. But you were saying you would definitely do it.
No, at first I was saying, can he do anything? And then Rob was like, no, Ghetto Superstar. And I thought that was Maya's song. I forgot.
Right. So, he could start that. He could start the show with that, and then he just
Yeah. But I don't want to hear too much from I want to hear Shakira from Wyclef and 911.
Oh, the carnival was the dope.
Going to November. Okay. Three.
Yeah. The carnival was a dope album, actually.
I
could rock with that whole
and
album.
Then Lauren rock out. Everybody know Lauren the band anyway.
Right.
Everybody coming to see Lauren. How many people going to see Wyclef?
But why could you think Wyclef could get away with some of his features?
Yeah. Like Destiny's Child shit.
Yeah, like he did. Yeah. What did he? Yeah.
Well, you said 911. Is that Wyclef or Mary J. Blige song? Whose song is that?
I don't know. Oh, that's. I think that's his. Oh,
I think that is his. That's a good question.
Because she's. Because I thought she was just doing the hook on that. I'm in trouble. No, no, that's him saying the hook on there.
That's because he does do verses. Please call
911. She does the verses on that.
I haven't heard that song. Why did they?
But he might. Who knows? He might have wrote it.
Yeah, he probably sing it. He probably definitely wrote it.
Mm-hmm. Yo, that it was some song. Speaking back to the Ye Drake concert, it was some song that Kanye was singing that I didn't know that he wrote for. He was singing Drake's song.
Yeah, find my love.
Yeah, I didn't know he wrote that.
Yeah, because that was when
was a part of the writing crew. It was like 14 people that wrote the song.
He produced some of the record that first debut record for Drake. Okay. He directed the Best I Ever Had video. So they were like tough early in Drake's career. Wayne was there obviously because that's Lil Wayne and Young Money, but him and Ye were tight back in the day. now you're gonna move to that generation. Someone, please.
I had to see whose album it is. it's Mary J.
Okay,
but I don't know the album though.
Yeah, because I don't know what album either. Actually,
That's
yeah,
weird.
But yeah, it was a good concert all in all. I mean.
Okay.
Kanye obviously went out there and performed shit that I didn't think he was going to perform. Like he went in his catalog, he went all the way back to Graduation. I mean, he went all the way back to College Dropout.
That's awesome.
And played and done some songs. And Drake said, "Now I'm going to stay with this 2021.
Oh, so that's where Drake went wrong.
Yeah. Because everybody was waiting for some of his actual hits.
Yeah, come on,
even
Drake.
Even though, he got a lot of hits. But he hasn't. I don't know if he has an album that just is like amazing. I don't know if he has an amazing. Like, does he have a classic album? His mixtape is probably his classic album, but that's not technically an album.
Like, I can't say that I bought a Drake album that I listened to frontwards, backwards, or you know what I mean. It's like the songs from the radio. You know the hits from the radio.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. Like, he has so many. So many of his songs on his album make it to the radio. It's like, the only Drake album that I've ever listened to was the last one. Because it was just so much hype behind him and Kanye at the same time. Like Kanye and 50 Cent did back in the day. That's the only reason. But I've never listened to a Drake album since him and Trey Songz was on the song together.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that was a mixtape. So, I feel the same way. So I don't know. What's Kanye's best album? Is he getting better? Y'all like Donda better than any?
No, I don't like Donda better than anybody. Yeah. No.
It grew on me. It's kind of, I'll still listen to it. It's in my recently played, song list. Yeah. Not the whole album, but but it's in my playlist. Mm-hmm. I think that College Dropout is still one of my favorite. I think it just
The
bought.
The Wire is my favorite song, my favorite Kanye song ever.
Who?
Yeah.
The Wire.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I don't know. But he's so different.
That it was not him. Like, I think that's why I like it so much. Like, it's hard to find a song that is kind of comparable to The Wire in his catalog for me. College Dropout is kind of like a add-on to it, but I just think like it was so raw and so emotional and so fresh out the accident that nothing else to me matched it.
Really?
To me.
I
love early Kanye. Like all the way
I like Champion.
Champion with the
from Champion. Graduation.
That's good, man. That was a really
good song. I did. Boom, 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 boom. When that beat rock.
His first three albums were hard to. He would be a versus. I think he kind of did verses. He kind of did a versus and Drake tapped out. I think if this was a versus, he would. Drake kind of tapped out. He was like, I don't got nothing to really compare.
It kind of was. It kind of was.
Three albums.
It kind of was.
Like you got three albums.
All the way up until
All the way up. Yeah, I don't know. That graduation album is, I think, maybe his most classic. I think that showed the growth from college dropout to just to graduation. Like, I feel like he really grew up.
He literally had a 7-year run. So his first album comes out in 04, college dropout. The album you're talking about, Graduation, that was 07. Mm-hmm. And then Watch the Throne came out in 2011. So between that, my beautiful dark fantasy came out in 10, and 808s and Heartbreaks 08, and then Late Registration. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So they had like a 7-year run. He did 6 albums in 7 years. Mm-hmm. And then Yeezus came out, huh? They all followed, right?
Yeah, yeah.
And then Yeezus came out in 13,
I like Life of Pablo. I liked it better than than I thought I would. But
I feel you. Touche. I feel like it's a definite. You could see the change though.
After Watch
the Throne, everything before Watch the Throne is the old Kanye, and everything after Watch the Throne is the new Kanye.
But he also said that when he was actually doing some though, he had changed sonically anyway in terms of
I would have loved to watch it. I'm surprised that they still haven't posted it as more of a on Amazon as something we could go back and play. Like, they really meant like live and that's it. Yeah. I guess, cuz now I've been still checking to see, and it's still not up.
Really?
Not up. I would have loved to hear him do like off of Late Registration and that Heard Him Say, "Nothing's ever promised tomorrow or today."
Yeah.
That right there.
Nothing's ever promised tomorrow today.
He did do that. He did Join with Lupe. He did
Touch
the Sky. Touch the Sky.
Did he do Runaway?
He did Runaway, yep. He didn't run away.
Dang, I'm mad. I missed it.
That's why Kanye's better than Drake. I don't know none of the Drake songs that I want him to do.
Right. Not like that. It takes me back to that year, Devin.
Every couple days going on the internet trying to see when the leak is going to drop for this. You know what I mean? Just so he can watch Kanye perform. I want to hear Kanye sing the damn Drake song that he wrote. So I bet you it sounds just as good or better.
Well,
because he's an artist.
Drake actually did one of the songs he probably wrote for Kanye. So they did.
What song did he write for Kanye? Do you remember?
Oh, shit. I forget. Yoda probably knows better than I do.
Yeah. I think they should know more. I should know more who writing for who. I need to know this more. Because I think the writing credits are very deserving. Like, people that get into the Songwriters Hall of Fame, I think they just as good or even better than the singers.
Oh, yeah.
Some of them were. If you're getting into the Songwriters Hall of Fame, you done wrote like 5 or 6, 7
hits.
It's not even hits. It's like my words.
Right.
Like, I don't care what beat you put to this. My words got me here. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Well, like Neo was that guy.
Yeah.
Before he made his own career. Carrie Hilson. She was that girl.
Yeah. But you think Carrie
John Billion is like that?
Who?
John Billion. John Billion.
Who he write for? I'm not familiar with him.
He wrote Monster. He wrote the hook for Rihanna.
Speaking of Rihanna, Dream.
Yeah. I know that other bull
songwriters out there.
Yeah, what's that other bull name? I think it's called his name is Sean something. He did that song with Mario and I forget the other guy. His name is Sean something.
Who did the verses with Neo? And is he a songwriter too? Or is he just a producer?
Who was that?
No, he's a songwriter. I think they were doing songwriter versus songwriter. Who was it?
Did Neo do any shit that he sung?
He probably did, because he wrote most of the shit he sung.
Mm-hmm. No, I know that, but I don't know if the guy is an actual singer that went against him. Isn't that kind of unfair?
I don't know, because I think it was Dante Austin. So Dante also sings as well.
Oh.
Jonte.
Oh yeah, that's who it is. That is Jonte.
Yeah, he writes. He sings as well. He had an album, I think, a while years ago. back in the day. He did have an album out. What else happened though? What else is going to happen? What else is happening? I don't know. Kanye trying to get back with Kim, and she said nah.
I heard.
Well, she said nah because he living with a woman, another woman. Like, how you gonna try to get me back, but you living with another woman?
Yo, Kanye rap about all the time how trash he is, yo.
Yeah, but you can't say you're trying to be better and then you ain't doing better. Yeah. You can't say you for Jesus. And that
yeah, he did. He living out his the record all of the lights.
Right, but that was like that was old.
My Kanye, mother, brother, fun. Man, mother, hate me in that order.
Yeah,
public visitation. We met at borders,
and I still want you.
That was I still Kanye. Want you.
That's true.
Did she take me back if my people is a war supporter?
That's not the life of power.
I made mistakes. He said I bumped my head.
Right.
So, Twisted Fantasy is such a good album, yo. The album is such good, yo.
It is. I didn't realize how good. I had to go back and listen to it when they said it was the album of the 2010s. I was like, yeah, let me go check it out.
Monster. It for me, Monster. It introduced Nicki.
Oh yeah. And boy, like she could hold her own. She was right, a lyricist right, for sure.
Yeah.
She was the standout on that record with all those dope MCs on her.
Right. And that at the time, I'm like, I'm not too fond of Rick Ross. He's not my favorite guy. But I'm like, yo, he shouldn't even have been on this goddamn song. It was real,
he
four bars.
He started the song right though.
I'm gonna listen to it again.
I'm a no good. He started the song as best as you could, I think. I think he gave you
I mean, Ross. Anytime Rick Ross can give you four to eight bars, it's going to be great.
Yeah, sure. I think
he definitely good to give you a half a verse premium. He a premium half a verse type of dude.
Half a verse. Yeah, it was a solid record.
Yeah, that was good, man. And then he reintroduced Pusha T solo career on that album. That was just a good album, man.
Yeah. So since we won't be here, anybody got New Year resolutions or not even resolutions, but just things you want to do in the new year or want to see in the new year?
I do. I just want to maintain and just keep getting, not necessarily maintain, but keep getting better at this lifestyle that I'm trying to build for myself and my kids. Mm. I'm doing good so far.
The lifestyle you're trying to build. What kind of like, Rick Ross over there? Selling weight
in his own way,
yeah, legally, but yeah, right. Man, I make money in so many different ways. Yeah,
but the way he said the lifestyle, like
like when I say lifestyle, like man, I don't know how. Sometimes you see different things and you're just like, yo, how are these people doing this shit?
I got you.
And then you just like I look at my kids. I'm like, yo, if my son or my daughter don't want no 9 to 5, I want them to have a 9 to 5 because that's the job they love to do. Like y'all wives love to fucking teach.
Right.
No, you gotta love that job. You know what I mean? Because it don't pay a lot. It's not rewarding unless you find a reward in it. Like the people that do it have to find a reward because you're not gonna get a bonus. Like you know what I mean? Like it's not. Mm-hmm. But I want my kids, if they want to do a job like that, let them. But if they don't. And they want to be on some charter planes that they chartered their goddamn, like, let's figure out how to do this. Mm-hmm. Like, it's much more to life than working. Working sucks, man.
Right.
Working is so hood. It is, man. Like, my boy, he's like, work is ghetto. I'm back at work. This is ghetto. And it is, man. Work is the fucking baddest shit. Like, who made this shit up? Like, it's stupid. 40 hours a week, 70 hours a week.
I'm not sure. I don't know if I hate work, but I do hate that you cheat me out of my weekend. You give me that Friday, the whole Friday. at least give me the whole Friday.
Let me come into work on Saturday and Sunday and give me the 5 days. Do that. I'll come in Saturday and Sunday.
Oh, yeah.
Give me Monday through Friday. fuck Friday. I want all of it.
I take that. Yeah. Friday, Saturday, Sunday. That's when you work.
This is bogus. Man. Like they giving it to us like we supposed to be looking forward to 2 days. That's stupid as shit. Yeah. In 5 days, we in the grind. What's the grind? Like, no, I don't want none of my children. I don't want none of my kids to be grinding. I don't want none of y'all kids to be grinding. Not unless they want to. That's dumb. Don't want to.
So you be responding heavy to those people that start following you and they got the crypto joint.
Man, delete block. What the fuck?
Oh, I'd be like,
what is happening?
I get so many.
Yo, follows every from folks day. That,
I'm like, what
every
the fuck? Day. Did I hashtag something that says, yo?
Let me like every Tuesday and Thursday, every time you put a post, I'd be like, beep, 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 beep. Like, stop.
Be like, and then they hit you in your DMs. Ah, I got a way for you to make quick cash.
Like, how? How? Show me how.
Yeah, but well,
you send me the money and I'll do it with you,
right?
But exactly. I just want to be better. I just want to like that's the lifestyle. Like I just, if my kids want to work, that's great. If they want to go to college, that's great. If they don't, let's just be productive and live the life you want to live. If you want to figure out a way to climb mountains every day and just be at the beach every like, we don't have to work, man. Like we're gonna find them a way. So that's it. So yeah, that's the lifestyle, man.
That's what's up.
How about y'all?
Dev, did you have something?
No, I mean, I think if anything, just to touch on some of the same things, just with family and just kind of being more productive, not being busy, but being active, you know, in the things that we're a part of, you know, because I feel like, you know, there is definitely a big difference between the two. Of being busy and being truly active and present in the things that you're involved in, that you're about. So whether that's, you know, being supportive of each other, you know, I think we can kind of pour, I think my 11 years as a parent, we invest a lot in our kids. But my goal looking back at those 11 years is now it's teaching them also how to invest in their family, and what role and stake that they have beyond just, you know, go to school and kind of receive. So now that's sort of my shift into teaching them how to also be very much what sustainability looks like for themselves and them being in a role of like a leader, you know, on the forefront of things, that it's not just all about being kind of in that receiving mode all the time, or something being like handed or given to them like that. Those are just kind of fundamentals that I feel like that are important now at the age that they're at. I think too, you know, we talked about it on other episodes. So I'm a couple months into therapy, you know, now one-on-one therapy. So that's heavy on my list to continue. I'm loving the results of it. It's really showing me how to show up differently, and really not, I've always been a good communicator, but I think that it's showing me how to avoid communication breakdown. You know, something can start good, but by the time it ends, you know, I shouldn't feel good if the other person is deflated or defeated, right? We should both feel like we were able to give those reflective, you know, be reflective, make sure each of us is heard, acknowledge all those kinds of things, so that we both actually feel like we're contributing to each other being kind of successful, not just in our work and like kind of our day-to-day lives, but just in supporting each other, whatever that capacity may look like for that individual. So
you know,
therapy's heavy on my list.
That's what's up, man. I'm glad that you're going and enjoying it. And also, man, like when you, it's so funny, like you're having conversations with people and you get upset, you got a real lot, like we always interpret things differently. And then but if you realize who you're talking to, and how much that person that you're talking to cares about you or doesn't care about you, then you can move forward in the conversation appropriately and use the energy that you need. Like y'all's wives, if y'all having a conversation, your wife is going to say something to make you mad because she knows she can't, not because she necessarily wants to or has to.
Right.
It's just, but if y'all are having a open communication and she says something that may offend you, it's not your job to be offended. It's your job to listen to her and then express to her that you're offended so that she knows. And in the long run, y'all are having an open and honest conversation. She's going to say to you most times, I didn't say that to offend you. I'm just letting you know how I feel. I apologize for how it came out, and vice versa with you guys. Right. And with any relationship, if you care enough about somebody, you got to understand whatever they're saying to you is not to offend you or to hurt you. It's for both of y'all to learn and to grow together. And that's another thing that I'm trying to do. And I appreciate you saying that you go to therapy, because I'm not sure if you go at all, Rob, if you've ever been, but like to have two of the four of us on the podcast talking about therapy openly, like it's a beautiful thing. Like as black, middle-aged black men going to therapy, like our parents didn't do this shit.
Didn't do it. And you know, one of the things
because we're old, let me just finish. And if they would have, when we were younger, we wouldn't be going, we would have been gone for 20 years ago. You know what I mean? For 20 years now.
Yeah. And going to therapy actually really taught me a lot about why my personality is the way that it is. Because I really went back to kind of, once I shared my story, kind of like my upbringing and the fact that, you know, my parents divorced, I was the youngest, right? I was the youngest of the kids. My parents divorced, and I really had to navigate my way through this kind of blended lifestyle between my parents, you know, being with significant others, right? And because of that, I had to really navigate in this whole kind of like inclusive environment. So it explains why I'm always kind of moving in this, like, you know, I want people around. I socialize a lot because I've had to navigate in these really inclusive and blended spaces, from being in my dad's house with his wife and their family and my mom's, you know, partner and her husband and, you know, and their family, like always had to blend and kind of like move in that manner. And spend half of my summers in California and then be back kind of transplanted back in Delaware. So it kind of explains it. And me talking about it, I'm able to even communicate to my wife so that she understands. You didn't grow up like that, so that might be foreign to you, but this is how I grew up. And that explains why I am the way I am. So the same way we have to, that's why we have to meet each other where we're at. It's not just one way, you know. Right. We grew up with very stable situations, but my experience was different than your experience, though it was, you know, stable.
Yeah. Right.
You know,
I agree.
Just so all of that,
you grew up in a single family home, don't mean you wasn't stable.
Right. So you know, it paints like who I am today. Is why it's like, nah, like I'm going to want to have people around me, because I always had a lot of people around me, you know. Just
see, I'm the different. My family divorced. My mom and dad divorced, and I was the oldest. Mm-hmm. And I remember being 8. My dad was like, "You're the man of the house."
Right.
So I've been working since I was 9.
To like, you know, in a role. Like,
yeah, just dumb shit. That if when I'm 13, 14, if I start talking to a therapist, I realize like, hey, you're not the man of the house, and you can be a kid and enjoy most of the things in your childhood.
Hell dog.
Doing the hell dog, you know. So good. It's
all good. What about you, Rob? What's your resolutions or 2022 outlook?
No, I think it's more about just being more intentional. And just intentional in anything, like you were like, even giving people their flowers while they're here. Especially, I mean, because I know we're in a season of COVID. Like, I just lost a cousin last week. So, and it's just Just being more intentional with the people and just and endeavors and doing what, just making sure that I stay focused on what I'm doing and keep and push through with that as well. And just terms of just being more intentional. And I try to be already present and family time and all that kind of stuff anyway, and be there all the time. So in that regard, just being, but definitely reaching out more to people and saying like, yo, how, just checking on them and seeing how they're doing, being more intentional and that. And I think that's the biggest thing. And just, yeah, I think, yeah, and just striving, I guess, trying to do, get my lifestyle together. I don't want to work either.
Yeah, I mean, I to that point of not wanting to work and work smarter, like, I think my intuition is talking to me more about being really investment savvy. Really to diversify, you know, my portfolio in terms of my investment has really been like for the last, I would say, you know, 10 years, it's really been all about like real estate. You know what I mean? Like that's been my go or my side hustle for so long that that's kind of the only thing that I've focused on, you know, with you know, just kind of your traditional, put your money in your 401k and kind of like let it grow. But I think I started to see in the last even 3 years that, you know, you really do, you either need to be on your dean and be like moving things around in these little buckets of your investments yourself to get those high returns, and or pay someone who has the time to help you manage it for you, because that investment that you might be paying out is definitely going to benefit you in the long run to have someone really managing Absolutely. Your portfolio, yeah. So that you can really capitalize the way that a lot of people are capitalizing right now in investing. So I think, you know, I'm you know, Lou and I, we've had conversations just about the whole idea of buying, you know, shares. I still have like my list in a certain order of like what shares I want to try to like strive and own, but they're pricey. Some of them are pricey, right? So, you know, if it's 10 or if it's 15 on that list, you know, each time I want to invest in them and kind of trickle and kind of buy into them a little bit at a time until I have every one on that list.
Right, you can definitely do fractional. Definitely can go the fractional route.
Yeah,
buy them a little at a time for sure.
Yep.
Because like Amazon, Tesla,
right? There's the ones that's big and that's high.
I got a guy that he just give you advice. He don't charge you for nothing.
Don't charge you. Yeah,
telling you where to put your shit at.
Yeah,
he's telling me move my stuff in my 401k. I'll be moving my 401k. People will be mad at me. I call them like every 2 months.
I move my stuff.
Excuse me. I need to do 6% here and 13% here. They be like, nigga.
Right.
Yes.
You gotta call your people. You don't do yours right online.
Oh no, I want to annoy them. I call. Oh, look, okay. Work. Yeah. Do some work.
The other thing too, which I know a lot of y'all are probably familiar with the moment I say it, but I was talking to Harlan about it, and you know, when you get into those higher level stocks, is doing, you know, group investments, to where like when you have a share that costs like $2,000 or whatever, you know, if it's the same way we buy, you know, season tickets to Sixers every year that costs us X so many grand per year, right? That's an investment, right? But buying those higher level stock in groups that you buy into, because it's just easier to get into it when you've got a group and you can buy more. So doing a portfolio of suggested stock amongst groups can also you know, just help.
Yeah, they got investment clubs, real estate club. Yeah,
that same vein, Devin, doing the I know you don't like, you're not into the real estate as much. You're trying to diversify a little bit, but the same people be like, yo, you just give me $5,000 and there's six of us. Now we got $30,000 and then we got a duplex.
You got
a duplex.
We got
a down payment for
a duplex. Yeah, those are the things that I'm trying to get more into. Yep.
Yep. it's a much easier entry to do something when it's 1/6 of the cost than it's just the whole cost. But you got to have people that are down to do it and willing to sign a contract and follow through. And if not, do it on your own, man.
Yeah.
2022 lifestyle.
Earn your leisure. Them cats would be telling you. Right. Cats is doing. They got apparel and everything. Them conferences.
Earn
your leisure.
Yeah.
All right.
I would say lastly, for us as a group, I think we need to really get laser focused on just thinking beyond where we've taken, you know, our podcast. Not that we're on the wrong track. We're on a great, great track. Being 3 years in, we're doing amazing things. So many people know about us. I think, though, that sometimes we can, we all can, you know, I guess you would say, is the word kind of edify? But we can all just kind of be better or optimal in what setting up, like what our role and what our goal is for each other. Well, for the podcast, right? And knowing that it's not, because it might be my idea or whatever, but if it's my idea, then the three of us get behind it. If it's Rob's idea, the three of us get behind it. If it's Lou's idea, you know, the three of us get behind it. If it's Yoda's idea, you know, get behind it. Because no idea is really a bad idea. It just came from one person. And unless it's really, like, always say, if it's unless it's detrimental, you know, and we can kind of see where it could lead to something successful, then, you know, we should get behind it. So that's it.
All right. Yeah. All right. Before we go, I want to thank everybody for hopping on. I know it's past the 1 hour mark.
A little bit.
But This has been episode 147. So I thank everybody for listening. Before we wrap up, we always like to know how we can find everybody on these worldwide webs. So Lou, how can they find you?
My name is Lou Belgium. I am on them Instagrams. Merry holidays to everyone.
Merry
holidays. Happy Christmas. Merry Happy Kwanzaa. Christmas. Be black. Stay black. We'll see you in 2022.
There it is. Dev?
Well, you can find Dev on Instagram at Dev Drinks Craft Brew. And it would only be right that I sing you guys out. And this Christmas will be a very special Christmas from me and LBC.
Yeah, don't forget me. I can't sing that good.
I put the LBC.
That's what I said. Don't forget me. I appreciate it. Well done. Well done.
Yeah. And you can also find 302 Yoda at @IAM302Yoda. You can find Bruising Banner Podcast on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter at
Bruising
Banner Podcast. I'm intentional when I say Twitter.
I see that. I see your intent starting early. You're starting early. You don't need 2022 to be intentional.
You can also listen to the podcast on Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts. Anywhere you listen to the podcast, you can say, hey, Alexa, let me hear Bruising Banter because we're on Amazon Music. If you want to follow me, Rob G, Rob Stay Bruising. I tried to do something different.
Yeah, I seen it.
It kind of worked.
No, it looked like he was like Goofy Foot. It was Goofy Footed.
I was too far. Right there. Rob Stay Bruising. Yeah,
follow Rob.
Hope everybody have a happy and lovely holiday. Merry Christmas, Happy New Year. And we will see you in the new year.
You better play that TLC. Have a merry, merry Christmas and a happy and a happy new year.
You did it. You did it, man.
Because I'm going to play the historical.
Donny Hathaway.
I don't know.
Christmas song.
Bing Crosby.
The one that people love Matt to hear. Matt when they think about Christmas, they always think about
this Bart song. Simpson.
Man, let me hear that, man. You okay? Man, it's
scene was so thick.
That's not a Christmas song.
It's on their Christmas, it's on the LaFace Christmas album.
What about this makes it Christmas?
And if you listen to the lyrics, he actually talk about how the season, you know? He'll talk about the season.
All right, I ain't heard this song in years. It's beginning to look a lot like Bulls. Follow my every step. Take notes on how I prep. I'm about to go in depth. This is the way I keep my season. Here's my get to rep. I kept, to say the least, no one can see. So I begin to piece my two and two together. Got some snowy weather. Have to find something to do better. Bet I just about to shut up that. Nonsense about some solid, solid. I got to cork if it ain't real, ain't wrong. Right. I don't matter what the season. Forever chill with Smith. I said my fifth. I chill with Wes and got my reason. So tell me, what did you expect? You thought I'd bring.